Hello everyone, welcome to our channel DexLab Analytics. My name is Niharika Rai and in this particular video I will be talking about skewness and gotitis. If you haven't watched my previous videos, you can click on the eye icon on the top right hand side or corner of your screen. You will be directed to those videos. So without wasting any further time, let's get started. In statistics, skewness gives an idea about the shape of the distribution of your data. It helps you identify the side towards which your data is inclined. In such a case, the plot of the distribution is stretched to one side than the other side. This means in case of skewness, we can say that the mean, median and mode of your data set are not equal and does not follow the assumptions of a normally distributed curve. So suppose that a normally distributed curve looks like this. A skewed data would eventually either look like this or it would look like this. The stretch is on the either on the right hand side or the left hand side. From this comes another term, or in particular the type of skewness, that is number one, positive skewness, and two, negative skewness. So when I say that a data is positively skewed, I basically mean that the graph or the curve is stretched towards the right side. So it would look something like this. In this case, the assumption is that the mean is greater than median and the median is greater than mode. Whereas in negative skewness, the curve looks like this, where the data is stretched towards the left side and the mean is less than median and the median is less than mode. So in positive skewness, mean is the greatest value. In the negative skewness, the mode is the greatest value. Whereas in positive skewness, mode is the lowest value. In negative skewness, mean is the smallest or the lowest value. Now let's see how we can create a data in Python which looks like these graphs, and also see that how we can calculate the skewness and how visually we can represent that data into a graph, and see how the way the data is stretched across. Now in Jupyter Notebook, let's first import all the necessary libraries that are needed to create a data which is kind of skewed on either side. So we are going to import NumPy as np, import pandas as pd, we are going to import statistics library and name it as st, from which we are going to use mod method. We are going to also import seaborn as SNS to visualize our data set, whether it is visually skewed or not. Import matplotlib pyplot as plt to add some additional attributes to our graphs. And last but not the least, we are going to use percentage matplotlib inline so that the graph is within the parameters of this sheet. Now what we are going to do is, in my previous videos I have mentioned that you can change the background of your graph. So here what we are writing is sns.set_style dark grid. You can also use white grid or some other arguments to change the background of your graph. Let's run this first. Now, once that is done, we are creating a list, an empty list within which we will store our newly created observations. Now, to create our data from the scratch, what we are doing is that first we are going to create a data which is positively skewed. Okay, so for that, what we are doing is we are using a variable which is k, and it has 0.1 value, and we are going to generate a data of 100 observations. So that is why we are using a for loop and using enumerate method, within which we are using range 100. Now, range method gives you only 99 data. The last one is the count per counterparts. So we will get the data from 0 to 99 instead of 1 to 100. Enumerate method, what it does is the number of times the loop runs, the value, the count values goes to this particular variable, and the actual data goes to this particular variable. So that is why we have used enumerate, because we need to use the count values. Then what we are doing is we are using this m variable and storing the j, and adding this j, adding the k value in j. So what is j? J is nothing but the data generated, and k is nothing but 0.1 here initially. Now we want to update the value of k. So for that, what we are doing is we are adding k, we are using k plus I. I is what? The count of variables. So initially the value of k was 0.1, but the next time the value will be 1.1 instead. Last but not the least, what we are doing is we are using the positive skewness list, and we are adding this m variable, m data, appending this m to the list. Okay, now the first time the loop runs, the data which we get here is 0.1 approximately. The second time when we run this loop, we have I as 1.1. So j that is 1 plus 1.1 is 2.1. So m has 2.1 and k is then updated. Now k plus, the k already had 1.1 plus I. Now I is 1, so 1.1 plus 1 is 2.1, and hence the k has been updated. So idea behind this is that we get a data which is incremental in nature, that increases like this. So that we get a stretch of values. Once we have the data, what we are going to do is we are going to see how my list looks like. So for that, I am just going to copy this list name here. Paste it and I'll run this. So I have a data like this: 0.1, 1.1, 3.1, 6.1, and so on and so forth. So the data looks like this. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to use the distplot method from the SNS library, that is C1 library. And I'm going to use this positive underscore skewness data, and I'm going to color this graph as blue. And I'm going to plot this in the form of a distribution plot. And I'm going to label it as plt.title, positive skewness, that is the title of the graph, this one. And the font size I'm keeping is 14. And I'm also labeling the x-axis and the y-axis. The x-axis label is data range and the font size is 12, and the y label is data frequency. plt.annotate is being used so that we can just add a text in the graph at these coordinates, that is 4000 and 0.002, and the font size is 13. Now once we plot this graph and add plt.show here, we see that we got a plot that increased initially at a very low rate, and the value increased at a very low rate, and then it started, the values again raised. You can see the 2000, 4000, 6000. Now the values are increasing at a very high rate. So the frequency of the data is quite low, but the values are high or on the higher side. While initially the data was rising at a very low rate, but the frequency was high because of the same reason. But now since the frequency is lower down, the data which we are getting it has a higher value but a lower frequency. So the data is stretched on the right side. So this is your positively skewed data. Now once we have that, by the way, the code sheet and the entire code of this sheet is basically given in the description box down below. You can go ahead and check out my blog for the same, so that you are able to copy this, or you are able to learn it practically or work around with this practically as well. Also, if you want to know more about DexLab Analytics, or if you want to learn from us, you can just go to the website www.dexlabanalytics.com. Yeah, that's it for the promotion. Now let's get back to this. Now what I want to do is that I wanted to check the notion that the skewness, the assumption of skewness is that the mean value is greater than median and the median is greater than mod. So here what I'm doing is I am using the same list and I'm taking a mean of it, np.mean of positive_skewness list. So I'm getting a result like so. Let's compare it with the median. np.median positive skewness. So here you see the results are, the mean is higher than the median value. And st.mod is used, again from the statistics library we are using mod method, and the positive skewness list here. But once we apply this mod method, what happens is that we get a big error. The reason behind this is that the data which we are creating is unique. Each observation is unique because a new value or new k is added to the j value. So that is why there is nothing there is no value which has a higher frequency. Instead, each value is unique. So that is why mod cannot be calculated. So so we cannot derive the mod. But we already established that the mean is greater than median here. Let's check, let's again generate a data which is negatively skewed and then see that whether the mean value is the lowest or not, or is less than median or not. So for that, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to use negative_skewness as a list. An empty list. Again, we are going to do the same thing. We are using a k variable with the initial value as 0.1. And for I and j enumerate, the counts go to in I and j, the data actually, actual data, the range value goes to in j variable. Now what we are doing is, instead of adding k value, we are reducing it from the j value. So whatever the j is, we are actually reducing the k value from it, and we are increasing the k value by I. So the negative skewness dot then we are adding the, we are appending the negative skewness, the m value in the negative skewness list. Once we have done that, let's again create a plot. Again, we are using sns.displot, negative skewness, the list that is we just created, comma orange, that is the color of the plot, plt.title negative skewness with a font size 14, axis label as data range with a font size 12, plt.y label, that is data frequency, font size 12, and we are again annotating, that means adding the text to the graph, that is minus, that is negative skewed, minus skewed, at these coordinates, that is minus 4000, 0.002y, with the font size 13. Once we do that, we get a graph like this. So each time that, now again, the initial data had a high frequency but a lower value, observation value. But as we move forward, the frequency reduced but the data value increased. The value which is getting subtracted from J is getting increased. So that is why we are getting a negatively skewed data here. So it is on the left side. Now let's again check the notion that the mean is the lowest or not. So np.mean negative underscore skewness, that is the list we just created, minus 1567 something something, and here we have the median np.median negative skewness. So see that the negative, since the from the minus side, the minus 15 point something, 1567 is lower than the minus 1157 51.1, we can say that the notion has been approved, that the mean is lesser than the median value. That means that when the data is negatively skewed, the mean is always going to be on the lower side. I have generated a data like this that is on the negative side. You can also generate a data which is actually has a positive value instead, and instead it is negatively skewed. The reason why I haven't used any other kind of a data is because I wanted you to see that how you can create a data set instead of just using a data set. Now again, the same reason why we cannot calculate the mode value, because the data is unique, so the frequency cannot be calculated. It basically mode is the frequency of repetitions instead. So that is why we cannot do that, because the data is unique. Now what we want to do is that we want to calculate skewness. Now how much skewed the data is, if you want to calculate that, let's get back to the positive skewness side first. So in Python, in pandas library, what we are going to do is we are first going to create a series of our list, so that we are able to apply the method which is necessary to calculate skewness. So pd.series is a method which we are going to use from pandas to convert the list into a series. Now if you want to know what is series, again you have to go ahead and you have to check the website again. There are a lot of blogs regarding series and artificial intelligence and so on and so forth. Or if you want to know more, you can just again go to the website www.dexlabanalytics.com. So pd.series, we are again creating pd.series and converting the list into a series, and we are storing in a variable po. Then we have a variable, then we have a method skew in pandas, which you can apply on this PO variable to calculate the value, that is the skewness of the data. I'll tell you the formula in a bit, the what formula is in the background of this particular method. So basically we get 0.64, that is the value is in positive, the sign of the value is positive, that means the data is positively skewed and to this much degree. Same we can do with the negative skewed data, that is we can convert the data into a series, that is NE, we are using a variable NE, and we are using negative underscore skewness, that list which we have created, and storing it in a variable NE. Then we are using skew method again, and then the result is minus 6-7. So here you can see that the negative skewness, negative side of the when you have to identify if the data is negatively skewed or positively skewed, you can just go ahead and check the sign, what sign it's using with the skew method, minus or plus. In case there is a, in case there is no sign, that means the data is in plus. In case there is a negative sign, that means that the data is in minus side, or in particular the skewness is a negative. So here we have minus 0.67, that means that the data is to this degree, the data is negatively skewed. Now the formula to calculate skewness is divided into three parts. Number one, when you have mod, in case you have the mod value, the formula will be mod minus mean. In case you do not have the mod value or the mod is ill-defined, if you do not have the mod value, then in that case, the formula which you are going to use is 3 mean minus mod. Now, in case if you want to compare or find the if you want to find the relative measure of skewness, as in the sense of dispersion, what you are going to do is, in case you have again, when you have mod given to you, then in that case the formula will be sk equals to mean minus mod upon standard deviation. And in case the mod is ill-defined or is not given, as in our case the mod was not given, so in that case what we are going to do is, we are again going to use the formula as 3, this is 3 mean minus median upon standard deviation. So that's that. So that is what the working force was behind this particular method. If you go ahead and press Shift Tab, you'll see that what kind of a method it is using, which formula it is using. So you can go ahead and check out the documentation by pressing Shift Tab. So that's it for this video. If you want to contact us, you can call on these numbers, or you can mail us at hello@dexlabanalytics.com. We are currently placed in Gurgaon. So, and that's it. I hope you found this video informative. And if you did, please click on the like button. Also subscribe us, because I will be posting a lot of videos in the future as well. Please click on the bell icon if you haven't already, so that you get notification each time I post a video. Thanks a lot, and take care. Bye-bye.